guys don't see that I'm killing. They are blind.
That was the last one. Let's see how it went for Graydon and his men.
Nice. Nicely done.
Graydon, tell me how it went.
It was a massacre. There were many men, and those were well armed. We killed all the Bloodseekers in the dining hall and the kitchens. But I lost three of my men. It was no easy task, believe me. Let's make this worth it.
Ravella, I will not be able to save you either. You'll pay for that,
Wes. Your
men are dead, and now it's your turn.
You? Impossible.
Ask your gods, whoever they are, to save your soul, for it won't be long until you stand before them.
To make him suffer just a little longer.
We've still a whole town to save. We have no time to waste on this vermin.
Now that the castle is taken, the rest should be easy.
Gather the officers in the Great Hall. We have to plan what to do next.
Consider it done. But if I may, you should no longer be wearing that vile sigil, Alistair.
Congratulations, Alistair. Thanks to your help, our men took this castle with ease.
Now, we have to take back the town.
What state are our forces in, Harwin?
The Bracks and a few of your banner men sent us men after I requested it. So we have a contingent of bowmen, another of lancers, and some of the people themselves have taken up arms for us. They're not really warriors, but they could prove useful.
It all depends on how we organize these men.
Yep.
And so particular care has to be taken as to their allocation. Let's look at the situation in town. My men on the outside tell me that most of Valar's horsemen are in the heart of the town, on the great craftsman's square.
The town square is surrounded by tall buildings, which could work to our advantage.
Perhaps. In any case, this will be a hard-fought battle. I will see to that myself.
We also saw some sellswords hanging around near the docks to the north.
We will have need of these docks and any boats we find there, if we are to evacuate the people once the fight is over.
Very true, John. Go there and take a few men with you. Try to take as many injured as you can downstream, while we try to control the situation here.
Understood.
The last strategic point is the town's main gate to the east. That is where the enemy will flee if they find themselves in trouble.
Let them try. The view from there is not the best, but it's a good place to defend if we set about it right. Graydon, you will see to that. I'm counting on you to hold back any attacks they make there. They'll have nothing left to lose.
Understood.
Very well. We have bowmen, pikemen, and villagers. What's important is to send each group where they'll be the most effective. To be clear, Ryman will be in charge of the central battle, John the docks, and Graydon the gate.
Now you must choose how to split the groups. Who will leave with me for the central battle?
Take the pikemen. You'll tire quickly in hand-to-hand combat. Better that you direct the men than go straight into combat yourself.
Maybe, but the enemy will be of equal strength. Everything will depend on the morale of the men. It's John's turn now. Who will go with him to the docks?
John could start the evacuation. The bowmen could help him. He'll need their range to be able to cover everyone.
If you succeed in this, John, River Spring will have another officer in its ranks. I guarantee it.
As for you, Graydon, you'll go with the armed villagers. There's no use wasting all our forces at the gates.
Very well, I understand. Graydon, John, know that whatever happens, River Spring will never forget your names. Now, let's get on our way.
Let's go.
May R'hllor watch over us in battle.
Victory, my lord! River Spring is back in the hands of the Sarwicks. Congratulations! Alas, the town does not come out of this fight unscathed. Graydon made sure that not a single enemy was able to escape, but he lost a lot of villagers. They too were lacking in battle experience for such a crucial operation. Captain Ryman was able to force the enemy to flee with his pikemen, but the battle was very tough. He lost 2/3 of his soldiers in the attack. Many a man of honor lost his life today. At the end of it all, we were unable to save many of the people. Things could have gone so differently.
We did all we could.
Whatever happened, the worst is behind us now. We have a lot of work ahead of us. We will soon be able to restore this town to its former glory. I'm sure of it. And it's all thanks to you.
This is not the time to rejoice. The town is in mourning, and the people need their last rites.
Have you not yet paid your respects to your sister?
Eliana was not the only one who shed blood for River Spring. I lost a friend today, and now I must guide his soul to R'hllor. Please excuse me.
No more so weeks. I'm not dead. Of course, and it's awake. I knew it. Chapter 13, Alistair and Mars.
I don't understand, Alistair. You say that you've taken back the town from the Bloodseekers. But where is Valar?
I told you before, he left a while ago. We regained control well after he left.
But everyone was dead, no?
Not everyone. Let me explain. So, there you have it. It will be a long time before the wounds that Riverspring suffered will heal.
I'm happy that you were able to take back your seat. But Riverspring does not concern me right now. I want Valar. That scum killed them. Do you hear me, Alistair? He killed my family and laughed about it to my face.
Calm yourself, Mors.
Calm myself? I will skin that bastard. I'll tear out his guts and feed on them before his very eyes.
Flames, calm yourself. You're not the only one who has lost something. Valar killed my sister right in front of me. He killed my people. I want him dead as much as you do, but we must think straight or else we'll accomplish nothing.
Where is that bastard, Alistair? Answer me!
He left, looking for Jane. He went to lay siege to Castlewood in order to capture her.
What? How does he know she is there?
Who knows? The Crown spies may have given him new information. Shortly before he buried me alive, I heard him say that he would lead a large army to Castlewood.
Jane, we need to save her. We cannot let Valar get his claws on her.
Yeah. I'm with you, Mors, but there's little time left. The baby is soon to be born. Once the child is born, who knows what Haldan will do to the mother?
You will kill her.
I don't think he will harm her. She's too valuable. But no matter what, we should take no risk. We'll save her before it comes to that.
And we'll use this opportunity to avenge ourselves, too.
Never fear, old brother. Valar and Haldan have taken our families from the two of us, and we will take our vengeance together. I give you my word.
However, infiltrating Castlewood will not be easy.
My dog stayed with Jane when we fled the castle. I know he still lives. We will not have a problem tracking the girl once we find him again.
That is indeed useful. Very well. What do we know about Castlewood?
When I was there last, I saw the dungeons, the watchtower, and the castle itself. That is where they're holding Jane. The castle's external ramparts are high and easy to defend. Valar will need many men to get through its defenses.
You're right. Valar will concentrate on the gates using siege machines to weaken its defenses.
Especially since the fortress is built directly on the banks of the Blackwater. The river protects its sides.
Of course. There's our chance.
How so?
While at Castlewood, I noticed the tower which provides access to the cells is directly connected to the river by a floating bridge.
But that gate was built to resist attacks. There's almost no chance we could get through it.
It won't be a problem. While I escaped, I took the dungeon keys when Alexander had the watch. We'll enter the castle by that method. We won't find a better way.
We must find a simple boat and a man who knows how to sail at night.
I know just the man. Yep. Let's go to the docks.
Lord Alistair, please wait. I beg you. The people of Riverspring need you. You must address them and organize a vigil. Even though the Crown doesn't recognize your title, the people already think of you as their new lord.
The people can wait, Harwin. I must leave immediately.
Leave? People were slaughtered and you want to leave? What are you thinking?
You heard your lord, Meister. You attend to the dead, and we'll take care of the living.
Save your anger for your enemies, Mors. Harwin, I'm aware that Riverspring is suffering, but our lands face another threat, and I must take care of it before it's too late.
Please be careful, Master Alistair. Riverspring needs you.
Trust me, Harwin.
See you guys next time.